Holy shit, I need a haircut. God damn it. All right, I'm guessing this is my world now until we open up. Anywho, I am so damn excited for today because this new entry, oh yeah. Hello everyone, this is my name is Daidarius and welcome to my manga haul of March 2021. Now while recording this video, I am still missing one more volume, but that would just have to be postponed until next month manga haul. Now, I have seen a pattern here, but it looks like that all of my manga that I buy are being delayed a lot. Again, I understand why they're being delayed a lot, but it might end up being that next month I might only have one volume for the manga haul. Who knows? If that happens, then I'm gonna delay it or do something else. But yeah, it's been a bit delayed. I only just recently got some of these, so anywho, let's just get started right away with my first entry, and that is Kajika in this Danish volume, this Danish edition. Now this volume is stupidly old, like all my other Danish volumes. And again, the reason why they're old is because Danish manga was cancelled back in, I think it was 10. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was 10. Back in 10, maybe early 11, Danish manga got cancelled. So this one has only been printed once, and this volume right here is from 2003. So it can vote now, or drink now, depending where in the world you are. You can drive a car, again, depending on where in the world you are. But yes, this volume is 18 years old. I finally got it. This is the final Danish volume that I needed to get. The other ones was Nicomachean and, of course, Sandland. So the only one I'm missing from... in case you don't know, I did this list back in January of manga that I wanted to buy, and there I listed four specific volumes by Akira Toriyama, and the only one I'm missing right now of those four is Django the Galactic Policeman Officer, whatnot. But anywho, this means that I am three down, one to go on that list, and this also means that if we take a look at the list over here, I can actually cross one more out. So yes, I'm slowly making progress through the list. In case you don't know, Kajika is a one-off manga by Akira Toriyama. He did it after Dragon Ball. You can see or recognize a lot of Dragon Ball things in here. Art style, humor, page layout. But even though this story is only one volume, it could have easily been a longer series. It even kinda leads up to a sequel or other stories in the end. But I do like that it is open-ended, because that means that Toriyama didn't have to actually commit to a long-running series again right after Dragon Ball. But anywho, this is a good read. If you haven't read it, try to do it. I haven't been able to find an English translation of this. I don't think it exists in physical form, at least not on Book Depository. So you might need to find a scanlation, or maybe if you're lucky, there's actually a digital version of this. But again, I haven't really researched it because I got mine. So, Kajika, and here we go. That looks sweet! Kinda still annoys me that Nicomachean doesn't really fit down with my other Akira Toriyama stuff. Anywho, the next one is one of my more bigger volumes mangas. That's a poor choice of words. Bigger one, epic one. No, it's the deluxe one. That is Berserk Deluxe Edition Volume 7. Now this actually confines Volume 19 up until number 21, Volume 21. And I also do enjoy that when you open it up, you can actually see which volume it confines in case that you are not good at multiplying or dividing by 3. Now I have uttered my dissatisfaction of this series, specifically the release rate, because only 3 of these comes out every year. And, I mean, I don't know what they're waiting for. But yeah, 3, so the next one is gonna come out in July. I believe it is the 6th of July, and then the next one is gonna come out, which will be Volume 9. It's gonna come out the 9th of November, as how it looks right now. We're not sure. I mean, things can change. It is Dark House. You can never know. But yeah, I'm glad that I have this one, but please, could we just pick up the pace so we can get the 13 volumes that are ready to be adapted into this, and then we will only have volume 40 in the singles missing until we get volume 41, 42 in like a century or something. But in case you need to start collecting Berserk, I would highly recommend you considering this since it is upscaled. It is in the original magazine size. But anyway, I'm gonna put you away. Looks so sweet. I'm just hoping my shelf can bear it because it seems like it might be... I don't know. Next one. That is Blade of the Immortal Deluxe Edition Volume 2. So this is the volume I didn't got in last month manga haul. This is one I was waiting for. This is the second one. Again, just like the omnibuses that some of you might have, you have to read this from left to right. So in the Western way, they haven't changed anything. Not reading orientation, not translations, not anything. It's just an upscaled and hardcovered edition of the ones you got in your omnibuses. So in case you have the omnibus, you don't really need to swift it out with this. I mean, you can, but you don't have to. It's the same content. You're not missing out instead of this high quality leather bound thing. Now, what I do love about this, except of the, you know, whole look of it and feel of it, is that even though it is in a grayscale, it is in black and white, it does show you in big format the cover of the volumes that this confines. Again, this should confine 3 volumes because that was what the old omnibuses did. So 3-in-1. It confines the volume cover so you can actually see it. You kind of get a glimpse of it here, which is the cover of the 4th volume, which was also the cover used for the omnibuses, but you are still missing out on the 5th and 6th volume, but they are in here. Again, I haven't started reading this yet. Boot! I will eventually. I'm not in a hurry. I have skimmed it and it looks awesome. It is beautiful art style. A lot of people have said that this is up there as one of the great samurai manga besides Vagabond and Wolf and Cup and its sequel. Those are, as far as I know, regarded as some of the best samurai manga out there. But anywho, I'm gonna get it up here and I'm just gonna have to wait until I actually am able to finish my Helsing Deluxe Edition because I want to finish it. Anywho, volume 3 of this is gonna come out in the 15th of June and then the 4th one will come out in 19th of October. So again, just with Berserk, we're only gonna get 3 each year. So again, that is a bummer because we know we're gonna be 10. Just wanna get it over. Anywho, the next one is the final volume. Again, I am missing one, but I am so stoked about this one in particular. It is Solo Leveling Volume 1. Now, technically, this right here is not a manga. It is a manhwa. And the difference between a manga and a manhwa is just, where was it created? Was it created in Japan? Or was it created in Korea? This was created in Korea, therefore it is a manhwa. It's semantics. If you call it a manga, I will not blame you. Now, this is great. This is awesome. This is something I've been looking forward to. Solo Leveling, in case you don't know, is an adaptation of a light novel by the same name, or I think the original one was Only I Can Level Up. I might paraphrasing that title a bit. But yeah, it's based on a light novel series that has been concluded. And I'm also actually considering getting the light novel series because they just started releasing that in English just before they started releasing this here in English. Now, in case you don't know, it is a bit, I will not say difficult, but it's challenging to actually adapt the manhwa to this because it is a webtoon. In case you don't know, the webtoon, you actually read it by scrolling down. So the page layout, the panels, everything has been made with the intention of you to actually scrolling, whereas this obviously not. I think they have actually have managed to do a good job on this part of breaking up some of the higher images and actually making them flow quite well in here. But you will also see that some of the images that's actually purposely stretched long on the website have just been tilted sideways in here, like this image right here from chapter 1. Now just be aware that in case that you're actually reading this on the internet, I will actually leave a link in the description down below in case you are curious about this. But just so you know, each chapter on that webshot does not equal a chapter in here. They actually put multiple of those chapters into one chapter in here. They don't cut stuff out except of just, you know, kind of scaling the images and editing them a bit. But besides that, they don't cut out content, they just make it flow like more of a chapter in here. And it actually, I think it works. Now, in case you are wondering, what the fuck is solo leveling? Basically, in this futuristic world, kind of similar to our own, there is a lot of gates opening up in the world, and these gates contain monsters. Some people has gotten special abilities and they hunt monsters. They are actually called hunters. Now, hunters come in different level. If you have read, let's say, One Punch Man, then you know of S rank, A rank, B rank, and C rank heroes. It's the same in here. You have hunters from S down to E. And our main character right here, he is Sung Jin Woo, is the weakest of the E rank. He's the weakest hunter of all. And by something that happens actually in this volume, he managed to get a new special ability. He's the only one in the world to get this. He is able to level up. So he becomes slowly stronger and stronger, fighting more and more monsters, stronger opponents, and kind of rising in the ranks of the hero, not in the ranks of the hunter. So he's slowly becoming an E, then a D, and C. But he has to keep it a secret because no one can actually progressively get stronger in this world. Once you have become a hunter, once you have been awakened, you cannot become stronger. You can try to do all the push-ups, bench pressing, squats, deadlifts you want. You ain't gonna become a stronger hunter. I'm sorry. He's the only one. It is an interesting read. I have read all the chapters on the website. I highly recommend it. It is best in the beginning. It becomes kind of a power creep or an OP character thing halfway through, but there's still some gorgeous imagery and some interesting fights. I'm just waiting to see where it's gonna go, because the story is becoming a lot interesting. And as far as I can see on the light novels, we are slowly getting to the second to last arc, so it's gonna be awesome. But I do highly recommend it. Check the link down below, because that is for free. It is fans translated, but it is a webtoon, it is online. And otherwise, just try to get this. Again, I am considering getting the light novel as well to actually read that. And I'm not sure why it's called light novel. It's just because it's a thin novel? I don't know. But yeah, solo leveling, my first manhwa. And it is in fact in colors, which is also a plus and something that I wish some of my mangas actually would do. Anyway. The next volume of this should come out in 8th of June. So that is any minute now. Where should I put you? It's gonna be moved at some point, because as soon as I get the 11th volume of 20th Century Boys and then the 21st Century Boys, it's gonna move. Actually, the 11th volume of 20th Century Boys has come out. I just haven't bought it yet because a lot of money was spent on this month manga haul, you know, deluxe edition and all that. So that is my manga haul of March 2021. It's not a lot, but again, I am missing one volume more and will be postponed to the next month manga haul. Now, the only thing I can say right now is that by the time you see this video, my review for Solanin should be up. And that means that during this next month in April, I will start reading Sondome so I can write and record a review. And then how long that's gonna take to actually edit, I do not know. But I have learned a lot from this review, because holy shit, I did everything the most wrong way you could do it. I gave myself too much work by planning too stupidly. anyway. I hope you do enjoy the review for Solanin. And if nothing else, I do hope that you enjoyed this video. Now, is there any of these mangas or manhwas that you have been following and wanting to collect? Or is there anything that you're looking forward to? Please, comment below and me your thoughts. And as always, till I see you next video, remember to stay awesome. Bye. All right. Time to read Sondome.